Hello everybody, I bought this Modbus 485 temperature and humidity sensor last week. I want to show you how you can use the Chipsee industrial panel PC to control this little thing. And I will show you how to read the data, and then in the next video, let's see how to build a graphical user interface in React.js to display those data, the temperature changes in real time. Today we will focus on reading data from the sensor and with the help of our Chipsee panel PC. You probably have heard about Modbus protocol, but maybe never used it, but that's okay. I didn't know that either when I first got this sensor. Luckily, Python has a library called Pymodbus, and when you buy the sensor, you can always get a datasheet from the seller, so those two things together should get you up and running quickly. I will show you how to wire these things, and I will pick the most important information from the datasheet. I will explain some concepts I think are very crucial to use this sensor, but I won't get into too much details. So when we look at this sensor, we can see it has four ports. This one accepts a 5 to 30 volts power input. This is positive input and this is negative input. And our Chipsee device also has a 5 volts VCC and GND. So we can use our Chipsee PC to power this sensor. And when I look around, it also has these RS485 ports. So does this 485 ports need to have a shared ground as these DC input ports like the RS232, which needs three wires and one of them is the ground. But when I think about this, I also know that RS485 is actually a differential signal, which means 485 signals do not enforce a common ground. So we know this DC input is only power input and it does not play any role in the signals it transmits. So the conclusion is we can connect the DC input to our Chipsee PC's VCC and GND, and we do not need to worry about sharing the ground. Then there's two ports. We have another two ports we need to connect. It's labeled A plus and B minus. So how do we connect them to our Chipsee PC? When we look at our Chipsee PC, there are four RS485 labels, the 5-, 5+, and 3-, 3+. So which ones do we use? These are actually two RS485 ports, and the 5+ and 5- is one port, the 3+ and 3- another port. So we can pick any one of them. I picked the threes. You can pick whatever you want, and I will show you the difference in the software program later. Only one variable needs to change if you picked the fives. So I've used a screwdriver to connect the DuPont wires, and I often use a multimeter to test the wires before I dive into programming. Because there was one time when one of the wires is not connected properly, and I debugged the code for a really long time, and later I found it's not the program that's buggy but the hardware. Lessons learned hard. And we can see there is a little red LED, which means it's powered on. It also means the Chipsee PC is providing enough power to the sensor. Now let's see how to program and read temperature data. We start with a Python virtual environment to avoid messing up with our other Python packages. The first step is to install Pymodbus library, and Pymodbus uses Py serial under the hood. Since our sensor is Modbus RTU and uses RS485, so we also need to install Py serial. There is also Modbus TCP, of course, but that's not our topic for today. If you are interested in learning these things, you can subscribe to this YouTube channel, and I will get to that in the future. When we write Pymodbus programs, one very important technique is logging. There is a code snippet I use to log the Modbus communication details. I will comment on them first, and I'll show you later why it's very useful. Let's import the Modbus client first with from pymodbus.client, import Modbus serial client. Then we initialize the serial client with client equals Modbus serial client, port, timeout, baud rate, byte size, parity, stop bits. Then we connect to the sensor with client.connect. This is the time we go to the hardware documentation. This port argument is which serial port our Chipsee PC are using. And let's go to Chipsee software documentation and find out what it is. We are using the 5-inch product of Chipsee RK3568 line. In the table, we can see there is a RS485 And bar 3, this name matches the printed name on the metal case. So this is a printed name. In the same table, we can see it has a node name. The node name is what the operating system calls this 485 ports. It's /dev/tdevice3. And this node name is also what we will put inside the Python function call. So the port here, we will fill /dev/tdevice3. If you did not use RS485 and bar 3, instead you used RS485 and bar 5, you can look at the table and find the name corresponds to node name /dev/tdevice4. So you will need to fill the Python parameter with S4 instead of S3. Okay, that's it about our Chipsee document. In this client initialization function, we have another 5 parameters to fill. The timeout, I usually use 1 or 2 seconds because we are using the serial port, which is usually very stable, unlike TCP, which sometimes has some latencies. So I will fill 2 seconds here. Then we have 4 more parameters to fill. These 4 parameters describe how our Chipsee PC and the sensor talk to each other. Well, we can program our Chipsee PC, but we don't quite know how to program that sensor. It's best to instruct our Chipsee PC to talk the same language as that sensor. Let's read the sensor document and see what is the accent it speaks or what is the protocol. The datasheet is written by a Chinese company. The English is not very accurate, so I picked the most important part I think we will need to know in an Excel sheet. The manufacturer of the sensor says the sensor supports Modbus RTU, which means our RS485 port, and the format is 8 data bits, no parity, 1 stop bit. This is a pretty common protocol, also people call it 8N1, where N means no. And the baud rate by default is 9600. These are the 4 values we will need to fill in that function call. So let's just fill them in. Baud rate is 9600, byte size is 8, parity is N, and stop bit is 1. If you are using another Modbus device, you can often find similar information on your datasheet. And this is what the device I bought needs to communicate with my Chipsee PC. Okay, now we have initialized the Modbus RTU client. Let's start the communication, which means opening the RS485 ports with client.connect. It returns a boolean true, which means we have successfully connected the Chipsee RS485 port to the sensor's RS485 port. So the next step is to read data from the sensor, and this is also the most confusing step if you have never used a Modbus device. So let's get back to our sensor's datasheet and see if we can infer what command we need to send from our Chipsee PC to that sensor to let it return the temperature data. Okay, the datasheet says it supports Modbus function code 03 and 06. And what the heck is that? I don't know. But we can Google the Modbus function code. Here's a table I found on the internet. We can see the code 3 means read holding registers. Again, what the heck is read holding registers? We don't know that either. But if it says read, we can assume we can get some data if we are reading something. Maybe that's the temperature value that's stored in those holding registers. And except for read holding registers, Modbus also has codes for read coils, read input registers, read contacts. I don't know what exactly those mean, but maybe the Python Pymodbus library knows. So let's check the Pymodbus document to see how we can read the holding registers. Luckily, Pymodbus does have a function right after the name, read holding registers. It takes 3 arguments. The first is address, the second is count, the third is slave, which is an integer, and the doc also says its code is 0x03, which is a hexadecimal 3. Now we are left with 3 parameters we need to fill. Let's guess what they are. The slave is Modbus slave ID. And back to our sensor data sheet, it says the address is from 1 to 254. Default address is 1. So maybe that's the slave ID of the sensor. So we fill this slave with 1. Now we are left with two arguments to fill. The first is address, the second is count. The document says address is the start address to read from. If we go back to our data sheet, we can see these blue cells, 00 and 00. The manufacturer says if you want to read temperature, the master, which refers to our Chipsee PC, our Python program, needs to send this value to the sensor. So there is also a start address to read from. But it has two values, one is high byte and the other is low byte. It's a little bit confusing. These are two values that all claim it is the start address to read from, but which one should I use to fill that Python function call? I don't know for sure, but good thing is they are all zeros. If I choose the high byte, it's zero. If I choose the low byte, it's zero. It's still zero if I combine these two bytes, which is 16 bits. That's also a word in computer science. So my first instinct would be to just fill a zero in that function call. And in fact, the correct way is to combine the two zeros and it becomes a word, which means 0x0000. That's hexadecimal in turn that gives a zero in the decimal world.